She's been accused of being dishonest about the true cost of her proposals and the tax burden they would impose on the middle class. She's also been criticized for making factual mistakes.
One of the criticisms of you is that your math is fuzzy. The Washington Post recently awarded you 4 Pinocchios.
Oh my goodness.
For misstating some statistics about Pentagon spending.
If people want to really blow up one figure here or one word there, I would argue that they're missing the forest for the trees. I think that there's a lot of people more concerned about being precisely, factually, and semantically correct than about being morally right.
But being factually correct is important.
It's absolutely important. And whenever I make a mistake, I say, okay, this was clumsy. And then I restate what my point was.
Is that should we, and if we work our butts off to make sure that we take back all 3 chambers of Congress, rather all 3 chambers of government, the presidency, the Senate, and the House in 2020, we can't start working in 2020.
She was working as a waitress and bartender at the time. Like many members of her generation, she says she had student loans to pay and no health insurance.
I really understood the frustration that working people had across the political spectrum. You know, when anybody is saying the economy is going great, we are at record levels, there's a frustration that says, well, the economy's good for who?
I mean, unemployment is at record lows.
I don't think that that tells the whole story. When you can't provide for your kids working a full-time job, working 2 full-time jobs, when you can't have health care, that is not dignified.
Congresswoman-elect Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez being criticized by media fact-checkers across the board after claiming that there's an easy solution to funding universal health care insurance. Ocasio-Cortez citing an article in The Nation tweeting in part, $21 trillion in Pentagon spending accounting errors. Medicare for All cost about $32 trillion. That means 66% of Medicare for All could have been already funded by the Pentagon. That's not what the article said. The Washington Post giving her tweet 4 Pinocchios, even despite her attempts to walk it back. They write, she cited the $21 trillion figure and said 66% of Medicare for All could have been funded already by the Pentagon. That's a direct comparison, but it's badly flawed. The same article she referenced on Twitter would have set her straight. The tweet is still up, probably causing some confusion. So, Harris, you made a great point earlier about the congresswoman-elect and that maybe perhaps we're all on the Republican side giving her a little bit too much attention. Or do you think that she just walks right into it with these tweets?
Well, I mean, you've got to have your facts straight. So,
that would help. I mean,
when you talk about the low-hanging fruit of do you know the 3 branches of government and that sort of thing, I mean, I guess it's funny. But it's not. And it shouldn't just be Republicans or
right.
people who are politically different than she is who are giving her grief over these items. Palestine is not a country. It's not a state. It should be within her own party because she's being held up as somebody who could really be a big voice in the future. And if that's going to be your voice, if that's where you're going, the facts need to be right.
We've started the wall anyway, and we're going to get that done. We're going to get it done.
You don't talk about President Trump very much.
No.
Why?
No. Because I think he's a symptom of a problem.
What do you mean?
The president certainly didn't invent racism, but he's certainly given a voice to it and expanded it and created a platform for those things.
Do you believe President Trump is a racist?
Yeah, yeah. No question.
Ocasio-Cortez told us she's determined to keep fighting for what's being called a Green New Deal, a highly ambitious, some would say unrealistic proposal that would convert the entire U.S. economy to renewable sources of energy in just 12 years, while guaranteeing every American a job at a fair wage.
You're talking about zero carbon emissions, no use of fossil fuels within 12 years?
That is the goal. It's ambitious. And
how is that possible? You're talking about everybody having to drive an electric car?
It's going to require a lot of rapid change that we don't even conceive as possible right now. What is the problem with trying to push our technological capacities to the furthest extent possible?
This would require, though, raising taxes.
There's an element where, yeah, people are going to have to start paying their fair share in taxes.
Do you have a specific on the tax rate?
you know, you look at our tax rates back in the 60s, and when you have a progressive tax rate system, your tax rate, you know, let's say from zero to $75,000 may be 10% or 15%, et cetera. But once you get to like the tippy tops, on your 10 millionth dollar, sometimes you see tax rates as high as 60 or 70%. That doesn't mean all $10 million are taxed at an extremely high rate, but it means that as you climb up this ladder, you should be contributing more.
What you are talking about, just big picture, is a radical agenda compared to the way politics is done right now.
Well, I think that it only has ever been radicals that have changed this country. Abraham Lincoln made the radical decision to sign the Emancipation Proclamation. Franklin Delano Roosevelt made the radical decision to embark on establishing programs like Social Security.
Do you call yourself a radical?
Yeah, you know, if that's what radical means, call me a radical.
Presidents should not be asking for more money to an agency that has systematically violated human rights. The president should be really defending why we are funding such an agency at all. Because right now, what we are seeing is death. Right now, what we are seeing is the violation of human rights.
Joining us right now with his reaction is the former acting ICE director at Fox News contributor now, Tom Homan. Tom, this must just have you steamed.
Well, you know, it's incredible. I mean, every time she opens her mouth, she's wrong. I mean, I suppose she went to college in Boston. She must be an embarrassment to that institution. She needs to do her homework. First of all, no child died in ICE custody. That was a different agency. That was the Border Patrol. And they did everything they could to save that child's life. All right? That child's in bad shape. You want to blame somebody for deaths in custody? Then blame the Democrats who refuse to close the loopholes that cause these families to come in the first place. When you talk about human rights violations, does she realize that ICE has arrested and removed hundreds of human rights violators from this country, including Nazis and people that committed war crimes in certain parts of Europe? We actually arrest a lot of human rights violators. And she ought to be saying thank you. She's from New York. ICE agents have arrested and removed thousands of criminals from the streets of New York that were released from sanctuary jails that she supports. So a thank you would be nice rather than misinformation that she always puts out.
Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, the new Democratic congresswoman from New York, is already making waves by calling on America's uber wealthy to pay a bigger share in taxes than everyone else does. She says all individual income above $10 million a year should be taxed at a 70% tax rate. That way, the extra revenue generated could be used to fund things like green infrastructure and Medicare for all. Now, the current highest tax bracket on the books for individuals is 37%. That's on all income above $500,000 a year. This is down from a previous high of 39.6% on income of more than $418,000 a year, thanks to the Republican tax law that President Trump signed in late 2017. Now, you see, the United States has what's called a progressive federal income tax system in which Americans are taxed at progressively higher rates within rising income brackets. America's lawmakers decided long ago that a progressive system spreads the tax burden more equitably between America's rich and poor. Now, this is how a progressive system works. Right now, you pay a 10% tax rate on your first $9,525 of annual income. Anything above that, up until $38,700, gets taxed at 12% in the next tax bracket, up to $82,500, and so on, until you reach the highest tax bracket after you make $500,000 and you pay 37%. All right, everything earned beyond $500,000 gets taxed at that rate. Ocasio-Cortez's plan is not fully fleshed out, but as proposed, it would add a new tax bracket for all income above $10 million a year. If you earn $10 million, $10,500, only the $500 would then be taxed at that 70% rate. That kind of increase could generate $720 billion over the next decade. That's not enough, by the way, to foot the bill for Medicare for All, which has a projected cost of, are you sitting down for this, $30 trillion over 10 years. But it could fund a number of other proposals, like free college tuition or universal pre-K. Many Republican opponents, and even some Democrats, would have you believe that Ocasio-Cortez's plan calls for a 70% tax rate on all income generated by wealthy Americans. That would be disingenuous. Others would have you believe that a 70% top tax bracket is unheard of, except the richest Americans did pay top tax rates of 70 or even 90% on incomes over a certain amount as recently as the 1970s. The question should really be, how progressive do we want our tax system to be?
People don't know about Puerto Rico, and one of the things that we discovered about ourselves is that a very, very long time ago, generations and generations ago, my family consisted of Sephardic Jews. The culture in Puerto Rico was that people would open their closets and there would be a small menorah inside.
Let's talk about it with Editor-in-Chief of the Daily Wire, Ben Shapiro. Ben, welcome. Great to have you. I know that you've raised some concerns, or at least pointed out that this potentially does not line up with some of her political leanings.
Yeah, I mean, I'm very sick of politicians just generally claiming that some sort of heritage allows them to get off the hook for their current political positions. I've never heard anything about Ocasio-Cortez's Jewish heritage before this. We've seen politicians like Hillary Clinton and John Kerry do the same thing, talking about their Jewish heritage, so that they don't actually have to talk about their policies with regard to Jews. Ocasio-Cortez is incredibly close with people like Linda Sarsour and Rashida Tlaib and Ilhan Omar, and she's not shy with about associating with folks who are fans of the anti-Semitic boycott, divest, and sanctions regime. So again, it's an easy way of avoiding the question, but it has about as much political weight as somebody being accused of racism and then saying, well, I once had a black friend.
Well, it's interesting. You bring up BDS, and you brought that up in a tweet today because she was asked, her spokesperson was asked about it on Friday and kind of gave no comment on it and where she potentially stands on it. But Yoav Litvin retweeted what you had said and said this: there's no doubt Ben Shapiro is the quintessential, quote, Uncle Tom of Jews. In his mind, endorsing BDS somehow outweighs being Jewish. Poor Shapiro, he was skillfully shut down by Ocasio and still feels sore over it.
Yeah, well, I mean, this is the usual line, is that if you criticize Ocasio-Cortez in any way, this is because you're obsessed with Ocasio-Cortez. Again, here's the reality. If you are in favor of boycotting, divesting, and sanctioning the Jewish state, but you're fine with everything the Palestinians are doing, the Iranians are doing, the Saudis are doing, the Yemenis are doing, the Afghanis are doing, or any other country in the region that has no human rights to speak of, but you're somehow going to boycott Israel because somebody's building an extra bathroom in Jewish East Jerusalem, then suddenly that's not anti-Semitic. Of course it's anti-Semitic by definition. I mean, this is, the State Department says if you are to treat Israel in a way you would treat no other state, then this is the definition of anti-Semitism. BDS is anti-Semitism. And Ocasio-Cortez has not disassociated from anyone who has associated with BDS or radical anti-Israel activity.
I know at one point you offered up, I think it was $10,000, that you would donate to charity for her to come and debate you. Any response on that?
No.
Okay.
And it wasn't just debating me. It was also she could come and just do an interview on my show. And I said that, you know, we could do it for no pay. I mean, but this was considered catcalling. She accused me of catcalling. I mean, has she looked at me? I'm not exactly a catcaller. The Orthodox Judaism sort of prohibits that.
It does.